Welcome to CET OCW lecture series. Today we'll be dealing with Engineering Physics, Chapter 5, Superconductivity. Superconductivity is a very interesting phenomenon because it's the phenomenon where the electrical resistance of a substance completely disappears or becomes near zero value when cooled under cell temperature. So this was actually discovered by Wundt in 1911 when he was observing the properties of mercury during cooling. What he did was he started cooling mercury, and at the temperature around 4.5 Kelvin, he observed that the resistivity of the mercury completely disappeared. Let us monitor a substance under temperature and then measure its resistance at the same time. Now, we start to cool the substance, and then we observe that the conductivity of the substance or the resistivity of the substance becomes zero at a certain temperature. So this is the temperature characterized by Tc. We are representing the temperature at which the substance becomes a superconductor by Tc. Tc can be defined as the temperature below which the resistivity of the substance drops down to zero suddenly. This is called the critical temperature of the substance, and it is characteristic to the substance. That is, for a different substance, the Tc parameter will be different. Okay, now that's the terminology. Now let's move on to a very important effect that in superconductivity called the Meissner effect. The Meissner effect was coined by Meissner. Meissner around 1913, that is 2 years after Wundt discovered superconductivity, Meissner came up with the Meissner effect. Meissner effect basically monitors the magnetic properties of the semiconductor with respect to temperature. So the Meissner effect basically states that there is a characteristic change in magnetic properties when the superconducting transition occurs. Meissner basically stated that when this transition occurs from a conducting stage, this is a conductor, this is a and then this is a superconductor. Meissner observed that during this transition, there is a characteristic magnetic property change for the substance. What Meissner did was, Meissner took an object and then he passed magnetic field through the object. Okay. When temperature was greater than the critical temperature, Meissner observed that the magnetic fields were passing through the substance. Now Meissner started decreasing the temperature of the substance. When the temperature was decreased below the critical temperature of the substance, that is, when the substance became a superconductor, Meissner observed that magnetic field lines failed to pass through the substance. Meissner observed that magnetic field lines did not pass through the substance. So when the temperature was greater than a critical temperature, magnetic fields passed through the substance. When the temperature was decreased to a temperature below the critical temperature, Meissner observed that the magnetic fields did not pass through the substance. That is, the substance behaved like a perfect diamagnet when the temperature was less than critical temperature. This can be equated or put in an Let's put it in a scientific equation. That is, the magnetization of an object, the magnetic field inside an object can be this is the equation for a magnetic field that is passing inside an object. Here H is represented by the external magnetic intensity. That is, we can say that the magnetic field passing through an object, the magnetic field intensity passing through an object, is the linear sum of the external magnetic field, and then this M is termed as the magnetization parameter. Magnetization parameter, which is the measure of the induction in magnetic field inside the object. When we place an object in a magnetic field, we know that magnetic induction occurs in the object. So the net magnetic field inside the object can be expressed in terms of the magnetic field applied and the magnetic field generated within the object as B is equal to M plus N H into mu 0, where mu 0 is a constant. It's equal to 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7. So Meissner is constant and the magnetic field can be expressed as in this equation. So we know that when the temperature is less than critical temperature, the magnetic field inside the object completely disappears. So when the temperature is less than TC, we know that this term completely disappears. So we can equate this as M plus H is equal to 0 or M is equal to minus H. So when the substance is acting as a superconductor, we can say that M is equal to minus H. Let us define another term now, which is called susceptibility. Susceptibility is the ratio between M and H. Susceptibility is represented by the character chi. It's a Greek letter chi. Susceptibility is termed as the ratio between M and H. That is that it is the ratio between the magnetic field induced inside an object to the magnetic field applied for an object. Okay. Now for T less than TC, we know that the object behaves as a superconductor. So we know that M is equal to minus H. Now theoretically, what does this mean? M is the magnetic field that is induced inside the object. H is the magnetic field that we apply for the object. So theoretically, this means that when we apply a magnetic field in this direction, the object is inducing a magnetic field in the opposite direction, that is equal to H. H is this parameter is H, that is the magnetic field that we are applying. In the magnetic field that is in the induced inside the object is M. So M is equal to minus H states that the magnetic field that is induced is opposite and equal to the magnetic field that we apply. So Meissner, this was a major observation made by Meissner. Now if we try and plot this out, we can see that we plot a graph between minus M and H. We can see that it's linear, that is M is equal to minus H is the equation. So this can be plotted out as such, minus M and H is linear in that is the initial observation made by Meissner. Next thing is we are defining. Meissner also classified semiconductors, superconductors into two types: type 1 superconductors and type 2 superconductors. Okay. Now we discussed that M is equal to minus H for a superconductor. That is, the graph between minus M and H is a straight line. Okay. Now, suppose that we are keeping the superconductor at a temperature T0, which is less than critical temperature. So essentially the substance is behaving as a superconductor. Now, we are increasing the applied magnetic field. We are increasing the applied magnetic field given to the superconductor. So we know that the superconductor is kept like as such. There is no field passing through the superconductor because an equal and opposite in the induced field exists inside, and H is the applied magnetic field. So suppose that we are increasing H linearly. So we are increasing the applied magnetic field linearly. So we know the relation M is equal to minus H holds for a superconductor. So we know that M will also increase linearly as the negative parameter of H. Now the problem is that after a particular value of H, that is if we keep on increasing the applied magnetic field, after a particular value, Meissner observed that the superconducting nature of the substance is lost. That is, if you continue to increase H linearly, after a particular point the substance is unable to induce a magnetic field that is opposite to H. So Meissner observed that after a particular value of H, this value drops down to zero and the substance becomes a conductor, that is a normal conductor or insulator, whatever it is. So the superconducting nature of the substance is lost when H is increased beyond a certain value. Now, this is defined as critical field, that is Hc. Hc can be defined as the value, the magnetic field applied, the maximum magnetic field applied, after which the substance ceases to act as a superconductor. Note that this is for a particular temperature. So, this is for a temperature T0. This nature acts, exists for a particular temperature T0 less than Tc. Okay, this, the substances that have this kind of a graph for M and H value or superconductor is called a type 1 conductor. That is the substances where this, the M and H value suddenly drops to 0 is called a type 1 superconductor. Now, let's discuss what a type 2 superconductor is. Now, the second type of superconductor is called a type 2 superconductor. So, in the same manner, we have a minus M and H graph that is linearly increasing. That is, we are increasing the H value, the applied magnetic field value, continuously. In a type 2 superconductor, instead of dropping directly to a zero value, we can see that a gradual decrease in the superconducting nature of the substance is observed. So, the superconductor has a graph like this, wherein a gradual decrease is observed. So, this is again the critical, this is a critical field after which the gradual decrease starts. This is the superconducting portion of the graph. This is called as the vortex state. This is actually called the vortex state, where the superconductor is in transition to a normal conductor. And this is the normal state. This is the normal state where the superconductor ceases to behave as a superconductor and goes to a normal substance nature. So this is a type 2 semiconductor, wherein the superconductor doesn't change abruptly. There is not, we cannot observe an abrupt change in the superconducting nature. Instead, it moves on to a vortex state, and then continuous increase in the applied magnetic field moves it to a normal state. Okay, so the difference between type 1 and type 2 conductors is that type 1 conductor, with an increase in magnetic field, the field absolutely drops down to zero abruptly. In a type 2 superconductor, it enters a vortex state, and then after a little while, it moves to the normal state.